Here we're going to look at a basic Rankine cycle where we're going to generate steam in a boiler. It's at high pressure and high temperature. We're going to feed that to a turbine to generate work. And then we're going to condense the steam, repressurize it, and pump it back to the boiler. And the question is, for this cycle, for the conditions we're given here, what's the thermal efficiency if the turbine is adiabatic and reversible? So the first thing we'll want to do is let's draw a diagram, label what we know, and I'm going to pause and draw that diagram. So in the diagram, I've labeled the information that we're given, such as the pressure and temperature leaving the boiler, the pressure leaving the turbine, and the fact that, leaving the condenser, we have a saturated liquid and assuming constant pressure through the condenser. So now what we want to do to calculate efficiency is we want to know the work, the net work generated, and we want to know the heat added. So net work is two places. We generate, of course, work from the turbine, but we use up a small amount in the pump, and the heat generated is in the boiler. So the equation that we're interested in is determining the efficiency. We use that symbol. And so this is the net shaft work. Put absolute value sign because the efficiency is positive. The net work, when we generate work and notation, the sign notation, work is going to be negative. So a couple other things we can do is we can go to the steam tables and can write down the information that we know from the steam tables, and then we can use that information in our calculation. So for example, the enthalpy of saturated liquid, and I looked that up in the steam tables, 226 kilojoules per kilogram. And we're also going to need the volume of the liquid because we're going to have to calculate the work using the liquid volume, and the volume cubic centimeters per kilogram. The other information that we can find from the steam tables is the enthalpy at 3. And this value again, 3399 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, because we have a turbine that's adiabatic and reversible, then what this means is that S3, the entropy entering, is equal to S4. And so S3, we can read again from the steam tables, for the superheated steam, 6.73 kilojoules per kilogram degree Kelvin. And so that means S4 is the same value. So first thing, let's calculate the work we need for the pump. And so the work for the pump is going to be the volume times the pressure change, because it's a liquid. And the volume we just looked up in the steam tables. The pressure change is going from 15 kilopascals to 8 megapascals. So let me pause and put those numbers in. So I have converted to 15 kilopascals to 0.015 megapascals. Now, when I do this calculation, what I'm going to have to do is make some conversions. So let's multiply this by 1 joule is a cubic centimeter megapascal. And then, since we're working on kilojoules, 10 to the third joules is 1 kilojoule. So if I multiply that out, I get the work for the pump. This is 8.1 kilojoules per kilogram. It's a small number. Doesn't take much energy to increase the pressure for a liquid. So let's now create a little more room to work. If I want to calculate enthalpy at 1, which is the value entering the boiler, H1 is going to be H5, that leaving or that entering the pump, plus the work of the pump. So H5, we looked up in the steam tables, work of the pump, we just calculated. So this is in again, kilojoules per kilogram. So 234 kilojoules per kilogram is H1. So now if I do a balance around the boiler, H3 is the value leaving, and we know what that is, 3399. So an energy balance around the boiler is going to be delta H equals Q. There's no work in the boiler. And delta H will be the final, H3 minus H1. That's QH, and I'll substitute the numbers in. So we have one of the numbers we need for the calculation efficiency. We now need the work generated by the turbine. And so in order to do that, we have the energy enthalpy entering the turbine. That's 3399. We need to calculate leaving, and the way we do that is we know the pressure and we know the entropy. And so we can go to the steam tables at this pressure and calculate the entropy. If we look at the steam tables, we see this entropy is between that of a liquid and that of vapor. So we're going to have some quality. So let's do that calculation. So the entropy, 6.73 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. That's what's leaving the turbine because that's what entered. And so that at 15 kilopascals is somewhere between liquid and vapor. So we have 1 minus x, we'll call the fraction of liquid times entropy of the liquid, those conditions, and x, which is quality, is the fraction of vapor. And I'm just going to substitute the numbers in from the steam tables at 15 kilopascals saturation condition. So here's the value for the quality. And once I have that, I can calculate the enthalpy leaving the turbine by the same process. In other words, enthalpy 4 is going to be 1 minus x times enthalpy of the liquid plus x times enthalpy of the vapor. And so let's substitute those numbers in. Again, using the steam table, saturation conditions at 15 kilopascals to get enthalpies of liquid and vapor. So now we have the enthalpy leaving the turbine. We can calculate the work because the energy balance for the turbine is the work is equal to the change in enthalpy because it's adiabatic, and exit is H4, the entrance is H3, so I'll substitute those numbers in. So here's the work from the turbine. Notice it's negative, and so because we're removing energy in the form of work from the turbine, so now our efficiency, which is the net work, absolute value over QH, net work is going to be work we get out from turbine plus the work that we have to put in to pressurize the water, so energy for the pump, absolute value of that divided by 3165 for QH. These are all kilojoules per kilogram, 0.382. So that's the efficiency that we wanted to calculate. Only 38% of the energy that we put in the boiler in the form of heat, we get out net in the form of work that we can then use.